Great music and great melodies are immortal. I don't care, you know, fashion change, culture changes, customs change. Great music is immortal. We still listen to Mozart today, Tchaikovsky, Rachmaninoff, any of them, any of the greats. Great music is it's like a great piece of sculpture or a great painting. It's forever, you know, for generations upon generations to appreciate forever, really. And that's I know that's a fact.
Just loving what I do and speaking from the heart, being honest, really. I can't quite form it down to a special formula or anything. It's just wanting to do great work, you know, and doing it. I so much see myself like you, or like the people in this room. I'm human just like you are. I'm no better than you are. I mean, have a certain talent with my art and songwriting and dancing and the drama and the whole thing, the show business thing. But as far as human, I'm just like you. And so, yeah, so it's no right for me to think I'm better than you or have an ego to walk on air. There are lots of people in my field who are like that, and most of those people, they fall. They really do, because they begin to treat people who help them badly, and to forget where they came from, and to forget about those who help them get where they are. And that's real important. That's why I thank all those. I thank everybody.
We have to stop the prejudice. We have to stop the hating. We have to stop living in fear of our own neighbors. I would like all of you now to take the hand of the person to the left and to the right of you. Go ahead, right now. I mean it. Don't be shy. Do it. It starts now. To the person next to you, to the left and the right. I mean it, right now. Go ahead. Don't be shy. Do it. Do it. Now tell the person next to you that you care for them. Tell them that you care for them. Tell them that you love them. Tell them that you love them. Together, we can make a change in the world. Together we can help to stop racism. Together we can help to stop prejudice. We can help the world live without fear. It is our only hope. And without hope, we are lost.
Well, I can't imagine, really. I have no idea what I'd be doing, because this is seems so right for me, and I'm here to do this, and it's my contribution to life to do what I'm doing, and I put my heart in it, and whatever good I can do, I do it, because I love people and I love making them happy. It's nothing like seeing your record number one, not for the ego, because I hate ego. It's for the fact that I know people bought it and they loved it and they enjoy it. And that's good.
I love directing. I love creativity. And I think when an artist steps forward with a production of some type, if he can express himself the way he sees it should be done, I mean, I feel it and I see it. I'm a visionary. So if I can give that, I do. And that's what I love to do with music, with film, with dance, with I love the arts. silly if you do that.
Tell me.
Because God made all things great and small. So that would be wrong. When other men have their Ferraris or they have their little, if it's an airplane or a helicopter or whatever they find, wherever they find their bliss. And my bliss is in giving and sharing and having simple, innocent fun.
I don't think in terms of color or race, or I don't say when I write a song, this is for the blacks and this one's for the white. I just write and it comes out and I'm influenced by what I hear. And it just comes out that way. I guess since I was small up to now, it's a total song musically of what I've been raised on. And I don't think it's in terms of color, because I don't believe in that. I really don't.
Traveling the world has been a great education for me. And if there's one insight I've had, it is this. Wherever you go, in every country, on every continent, people yearn and hunger for only one thing, to love and be loved.
Throughout my life, I have only tried to help thousands upon thousands of children to live happy lives. It brings tears to my eyes when I see any child who suffers. I am not guilty of these allegations, but if I am guilty of anything, it is of giving all that I have to give to help children all over the world. It is of loving children of all ages and races. It is of gaining sheer joy from seeing children with their innocent and smiling faces. It is of enjoying through them the childhood that I missed myself. If I am guilty of anything, it is of believing what God said about children. Suffer little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. In no way do I think that I am God, but I do try to be God-like in my heart. I am totally innocent of any wrongdoing, and I know these terrible allegations will all be proven false.
It has not. I've had no plastic surgery on my face, just my nose. It helped me breathe better so I can hit higher notes. And everybody in Hollywood get plastic surgery. Plastic surgery wasn't invented for Michael Jackson.
I've been living in that kind of life all my life. The tabloid press, that kind of press, not the press, the tabloid, the paparazzi, that type. I've been running for my life like that, hiding, getting away. You can't go that way because they're over there. And let's go this way. Pretend we're going that way and we'll go that way. Somebody should say, hold on, stop. This person deserved their privacy. You are not allowed to go there. I go around the world dealing with running and hiding. I can't take a walk in the park. I can't go to the store. I have to hide in a room. You feel like you're in prison.
When you say bed, you're thinking sexual. They make that sexual. It's not sexual. Because I think I've traveled the world over 8 times around the world, and I go to I do as many hospitals and orphanages as I do concerts. But of course it's not covered. That's not why I do it for coverage. I do it because it's from my heart. And there are so many children in the cities who've never seen mountains, who haven't been on a carousel, who haven't petted a horse or a llama, who've never seen them. So if I can open my gates, and those gates open, and that bliss, an explosion of screaming and laughter from the children, and they run past the bridge, they run on the rides, I say, thank you, God. I feel I won God's smile of approval, you know, because I'm doing something that brings joy and happiness to other people.
This is their time. And this you should not do. You should not say he's an animal. Should not say he's Jacko. I'm not a Jacko. I'm Jackson.
that I started breaking the all-time record in record sales. I broke Elvis's records. I broke Beatles' records. The minute it became the all-time best-selling album in history of the Guinness Book of World Records, overnight, they called me a freak. They called me a homosexual. They called me a child molester. They said I tried to bleach my skin. They made everything to turn the public against me. This was all complete, complete conspiracy. You have to know that.
The magic, the wonder, the mystery, and the innocence of a child's heart are the seeds of creativity that will heal the world. I really believe that.
See, the thing is, artists seem to get in the way of the music. Get out of the way of the music. You know, don't write the music. Let the music write itself.
Transcends international boundaries and it heals the wounds of hatred, racial prejudice, bigotry, and ignorance. It is the ultimate truth at the heart of all creation. I would also like to thank God and my mother and father, Catherine and Joseph Jackson. Thank you once again. I love you all.